Step 2, Creating Schedules. In this step, we will become familiar with ArchiCAD's interactive element schedules. These schedules enable designers to enhance modifications to the central building database. The changes in the element schedules will consequently be carried to all the other project views, including sections and elevations, detail drawings, layout sheets, and so on. Switch to the project map in the navigator. Open the Schedules container. Click once on the D1 door schedule to select it. Right-click and select the Scheme Settings option from the context menu. Switch to the Schemes panel in the Scheme Settings dialog and select the D1 door schedule item. The Criteria and Fields panels display the settings belonging to this schedule scheme. You can set conditions in the Criteria panel. If an element meets these conditions, then it will be listed as part of the current schedule. In our case, only doors will be listed. No other element types will be considered. In the Fields panel, you can set what type of data will be generated in the schedule for the listed elements. The General category contains parameters that all elements have. Further, there are element-specific categories as well. These parameters are specific to the element type, and other element types may not have them. Our Door Schedule field will include the name of the library part, the width and height of the door, and display its 2D symbol and 3D view. Click Cancel to leave the dialog. Right-click again on the D1 door schedule item in the project map, and select Open from the context menu to open and generate this schedule. The schedule window opens, and depending on your processor speed, it will spend some time generating the schedule's data. The schedule will be displayed shortly. Click the Fit Width button located to the left of the horizontal scroll bar to fit the width of the schedule to fill the available screen estate. To the left of the schedule window, you can see a vertical pane that lets you specify schedule options and format options. The Show Uniform Entry Items as a Single Entry option will cause elements having identical parameters to display in one row. Under Format Options, you can individually set font, pen, text size, and alignment, and border pen settings for each of the various areas of the schedule. Select Value in the Apply To field, and enter 3.5 in the Text Height field. As you can see, all values have increased in text size. Select Total in the Apply To field and enter 3.5 in the Text Height field. Make sure that the bold toggle in the Total Font Style option is enabled. Find the first D1 Sidelight Transom 12 row in the door schedule. The height of the door is 2700 millimeters. Whereas most of the doors in the building are 2800 millimeters. Let's look into this discrepancy. Click anywhere in this row to select it. A blue highlight is shown behind the whole row. As you can notice, the width and height columns have turned into text boxes into which you can enter new values. The new values will be instantly applied to all the corresponding building elements in the central design database. Interactive element schedule means that the design model can be directly modified through element schedules. Before modifying this door, let's have a quick look at it in the project. With the row still highlighted, click the Select in 3D button at the top of the schedule window. ArchiCAD selects the doors and displays them in the 3D window. You may have to zoom out to see all the doors selected. You may also have to use the orbit navigation mode to get the best 3D view of the selected doors. The doors are located at the passages, and there is no special reason to have these lower than the others. Select the Window, Schedule D1 Door Schedule menu item to return to the schedule. Click click into the height column of the selected row. The highlight of the clicked cell changes to a lighter blue, showing that we can now modify its content. Select the text 2700 and type 2800 to replace the previous height value. The change will be made instantly after you're done with the height update. Note that the doors in the 3D window have been automatically changed to reflect the new height value. We are now finished modifying our interactive door schedule. Close the interactive door schedule and return to the floor plan project view.